One of the things I love about this guy, and I spotted him because he's random. You're not a household name, but I love the smartsmanship, and that's a big part of entrepreneurship. Smartsmanship, finding a hole, finding a gap, right? Game altering play, finding something that's different. And he did that in the automobile business, and he's killing it, just absolutely killing it. And I love that because you can do that. You can do that today. You could do that now. Figure out what somebody needs and make it happen. And this is such a simple product. I'm just jealous because I didn't think of it, but it's brilliant. Welcome. How are you, my friend?
Thank you, Brian.
So tell me what Seal Skin Covers does, and how'd you come up with this idea?
Yeah, no. Well, first, I definitely want to thank you for having me on your show, Brandon. It means a lot. You know, as an entrepreneur, I feel like there's some glamour to it, you know, like the idea of being an entrepreneur. But then you find that it's not only tough, but it's also a little lonely too. You know, sometimes you feel like...
How so?
Well, I mean, of course you want to be able to, you know, communicate with your team and be open-minded and kind of work together. And when you get in your car, you go home and you're driving home at night and it's just you and those ideas, you start to feel like it's lonely, and connecting with other entrepreneurs and other leaders, it helps, you know. And that's what I want to do for 2019. That's sort of my personal goal, is to get out of my comfort zone. This is my first podcast ever. Yeah, so if I look nervous, that's only because I am.
First of all, there's no such thing. I mean, really, this is just, we're just having a conversation.
Absolutely,
two guys here on a park bench. But, you know, there's a lot of people out there that are more nervous than you.
Yeah, yeah.
Trying to figure out how to get off the bench and get their game going, how to get their product in play.
Yeah.
First of all, tell me what your product is and what it does.
Sure. So basically, what we do is we're selling waterproof, breathable car covers, boat covers, jet ski covers, UTV covers, snowmobile covers. So what they are a semi-custom fit cover for your machine. They're pretty much the best fit, best price possible. So most customers probably...
Why? How'd you come up with this idea? I mean,
no.
And why do people need a cover for their car, their snowmobile, or whatever?
Well, believe it or not, Brandon, I mean, people love their cars. You know, there's some people who are really passionate about their vehicles. Especially about some of the classics, some of the sports cars. You'd be shocked. I mean, I've heard wives complain about the love and the relationship a guy has with his vehicle, you know, or his motorcycle or his boat. And so a cover is probably one of the most important accessories you can maybe buy for your car. It extends the life of the vehicle. Anytime you leave a vehicle alone, whether you're maybe going on vacation or maybe you're at work and next to a construction site, having a portable car cover, easy to install, just throw it on your car, you know that your car is going to be safe. It helps.
Okay, that's cool. No. So how do you get started in this business?
Yeah.
How hard was it to get started? And what's been your biggest challenge?
Well, I mean, to take it sort of a little bit to the beginning, Brandon, it all started out of college. You know, it's one of those things where everyone out of college is like trying to figure their life out. It's one of those things where it's like, what do I do? You know, I always wanted to be an entrepreneur. It's one of those things where, you know, you see it on TV. And this was when the Facebook craze was going and young entrepreneurship.
If you're out there and you're in college and you're thinking about what you want to do and don't know, can you please just, can you participate? I would love to hear from you because I love hearing that kind of trial and tribulation.
Yeah.
Because I was one of those people too. I was really confused coming out of college. I thought I wanted to go in hotel restaurants. Yeah. If you're out there, tell me where you're confused about. Tell me what you're thinking about when you're in college. Yeah. And, you know, I think if you are very confused, you're in a good place.
Yeah.
A really good place. If you're not confused, I would be more concerned, right?
I can't agree more, Brandon. I feel like that's what they didn't tell me. You know, this whole thing of, you almost make it sound like you need to have everything figured out, you know, and that's scary, man.
I mean, how much fun would life be if you knew exactly everything was going to happen?
Absolutely.
I think it would be boring.
Yeah, for sure.
Right?
No, I mean, without a doubt. So out of college, me and a bunch of friends were watching like the Facebook movie and these young entrepreneurship, and young entrepreneurship in itself was really becoming really popular. So we're like, okay, well, what are we good at? What do we want to do? So we've actually started just building small websites for small businesses. So we started going out there, hunting for small businesses, looking to build websites for them. And in the beginning, not so bad. You know, when you're like 19, 20, 21, it's easier to sort of get by on chicken noodle soup for lunch, breakfast, and dinner, you know?
And if you work a few weeks in a row without a day off, no biggie.
Yeah, it's not a big deal. Yeah, we just started building small business, small websites for small businesses, helping them with marketing.
How do you get to the skins, though? Like, how does, I mean,
we're definitely,
that's so random, and it's just so random.
And it's a pretty cool story of how I got there, actually.
All right, I'm ready for it.
So basically, yeah, we started off building websites for small businesses, and in the beginning, sort of excited. You know, you get that euphoria. I'm starting my own business, and all of a sudden, when you start to have some bills and some responsibilities, and things start to get a little bit tough. So a couple of friends of mine that we kind of started off with quit. You know, one got married. Hey, this was like 2-3 years of trying to put it together, trying to get a business together. Hey, this is not for me. We're not going anywhere. Quit. And I find myself. I remember this one time. We had some customers. I remember this one time. We had a little tiny office here in Tarrytown, and I had a customer in White Plains. I'm going to go see him. It's raining, you know, a little drizzle, running a little late. I'm driving, can't find his office. I'm driving around the building, can't find it, under stress. Park the car, Brandon, it starts pouring. I mean, it literally starts coming down. I'm looking at my phone. My phone is dying. The GPS isn't working. I'm getting, cars were pulling over because the windshield wipers couldn't keep up with the rain. It got to a point where I was so wet, it no longer mattered that I was outside. It no longer mattered that, you know, it was raining. Nothing mattered. It actually got to a point where I had to make a decision. Either I quit at that moment right there and maybe, you know, just call it quits, or break through and almost become invincible. I remember, you know, it's a little bit of an emotional kind of time as well, but I remember like literally almost breaking down where I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna quit.
You're a little emotional right now.
I mean, it was a tough thing.
So, and you decide then, now all of a sudden you have this moment.
I left the meeting completely. I walked from White Plains all the way to Tarrytown in the rain.
Which is not close.
Which is, it took me maybe 40 minutes or so. I got to the office. Took my clothes off, was just in boxers, went through my client list, immediately eliminated all the clients that I felt like were either wasting my time or not worth my time. I sort of reevaluated everything that I was doing. Something clicked, Brandon, and literally like it just helped me focus in a way that I had never been focused in that way. That breakdown, you know, it really sort of helped me get there. And so I get to my office, whip out my client list, immediately categorized clients that I felt like had potential, clients that were not invested in me and weren't worth my time, immediately eliminated them, looked at the clients that I felt like had potential, tried to see some patterns, noticed that a lot of the clients that were in the manufacturing space, people who were used to making a product and putting that product in other stores, were now interested in selling directly online, needed web and marketing help, noticed that they were a little more invested, you know, had some more potential. Looked at those businesses, and then one of those businesses happened to be a car cover manufacturer company. I called them, listen, the proposal I sent over to help you build your website, scratch that, I'll build the website for free. If you could just let me kind of take over and lead the whole thing. And I'll build you the whole website if you could let me be a partner.
And
the guy's like, hey, listen, that sounds amazing, go ahead. So I had, this was after years of sort of scraping by, I had, you know, saved some money, built the website myself, me and my partner. Scraped all the data, all the websites, went and took pictures of all the products, did everything on our own. And we noticed is a lot of people were selling car covers based on size, because there's really only two types of car covers. You know, this was like maybe 6-7 years ago, or I would say 10 years ago.
An SUV.
Either you were buying a fully custom cover. I mean, somebody comes out and either is measuring your boat, taking 6 weeks to make it, charging you an arm and a leg, or you were getting a one-size-fits-all thin cover in Walmart, right? And so what these guys were doing, they were selling car covers that were good quality based on size. So if you wanted to buy a car cover, if you wanted to buy a boat cover, you had to measure your own boat and then go online and then find the size that fit. What we did was we took all the vehicles, started with cars, we organized them based on their length, their width, their height, and then what we did is we started auto-matching the SKUs that the manufacturer had developed to the vehicles themselves and allowed our customers to shop by year, make, and model.
So you did some of the work for them.
We did.
So it's just easy, click, and pick.
So it's just easy click and pick. Customers came to our website, just gave us the year, make, and model. We got them the right cover. Our competitors, you went to their website, picked the size. Brandon, within six months,
simple.
We
that's
went
just
from
just simple, man. Come
simple,
on.
I mean, you'd be good ideas are simple ideas. You know, that's what I found is when you're making it a little bit too hard, it's hard to explain. You need a genius to get it. something's probably wrong.
So you get the website rolling. Obviously, you're going to get a boost in revenue because you actually did what the people like. I'd go to that site, go, oh, shit, I'm not going to go measure my car. And then you forget and you never went back there.
Exactly.
So now you like a click and pick, and all of a sudden you're rock and rolling. And also, you offer custom colors and all that stuff or no?
No. We
it's like a one or two color,
it's we focus on protection. Okay. You know, for us right now, is that's and we'll talk more about that. That's where we're going to now, is to allow more customization.
But what happened to the guy whose company it was? Did you boot him out to do your own thing?
No, me and my, we're still working together today.
So you're still partners with that guy?
Absolutely.
The best movie ever made.
The website, branding was 6 months. Within 6 months, went from zero to $1 million in sales. I mean, it literally blew up. You know, here we are. Here I was with maybe $2,000 in my bank account, with my parents telling me I need to quit because why did I go to college? This, you know, you gave it your best, get a job. My friends getting engaged, buying cars.
Thank God for parents, aka the accountability police, that keep you somewhat straight and ordered. They know that you just cannot flounder for life.
Although
they're never going to give up on you.
No.
Nor should they.
They want the best for you.
But they shouldn't be letting you flounder and just let you do anything.
For sure. Right? For sure. I mean, I was this close to quitting. You know, if I feel like that was my last chance. If that didn't work, I wouldn't be here sitting talking to Brandon.
I love it. So now, where are your sales now, by the way?
So now we're at...
So that $1 million got my attention.
Yeah, $7 million in sales. We went to... We went from cars, we added boats, jet skis, and the rest of the sport utility vehicles.
How big is this market?
So right now we're sort of just scratching the surface, Brandon. I mean, we're literally selling everything that we're selling directly on our website.
Literally scratching the surface.
Our product right now is in no other stores. We don't do any wholesale business. It's
Why?
Just literally, honestly, it's just been tough to keep up with the demand of just our website itself. I mean, for us, the partner we were working with wasn't even prepared in the way that it took to. So for us, we had to take over a lot of the warehousing, inventory management, developing the product. You know, people were used to selling, just any old cover.
Are you fulfilling and shipping?
We are.
Where? Where do you do that?
We do it out in Jersey.
You have a warehouse in Jersey?
We have a warehouse in Jersey.
You live in Westchester.
I don't go to the warehouse every day. Okay. Our corporate office.
Why Jersey?
Well, warehousing is a little bit cheaper. So in terms of just being close
can
to core.
Can I bid on that business? I'll fulfill those things. That can't be taking up a lot of space.
We have 11,000 square foot warehouse. It's not big.
Just for you?
Just for us.
Oh, so you got like 100,000 units in stock?
Now we're moving into car trunk organizers, roof bags. So we're moving
into 11,000 square feet in warehouse space
for boat covers, jet ski covers.
How many units do you carry in your inventory?
About maybe 40,000.
Oh, 40, wow.
Yeah, 40,
so
50,
it's real.
It's pretty real.
I'd still like to bid on that business.
I mean, Brandon, we're just getting started. Give me a few more years.
I'm talking about. Why not get some marketing help and then let me bid on that business. I can fulfill and ship. I got 45,000 square feet in my warehouse, and I'm looking to get rid of 10.
Well, I mean, hey, listen.
Just talking. A brother's got to make a – I mean, a brother's got to bid. I got to at least jump in on this. That's cool. I love your model.
Yeah.
Tell me your biggest – challenge. Tell me what's been troublesome to you. What's keeping you up at night?
I think the biggest challenge now is what we've been good at, I would say, is three things. Basically, we have a very customer-focused shopping experience. Person comes to our website. Not only do we get them the cover they need for the year, make, and model, but as soon as you type it in, we'll load it on your screen automatically. So imagine visiting the website. You give us
what
a year, make, and model.
Sealskincovers.com,
www.sealskincovers.com.
Should we give away like a car? Should we give away
absolutely.
One? Or is that like cool?
For sure.
I don't want to put you on the spot.
No. We can definitely give away a car cover.
The way the weather's been on the East Coast, everybody out there needs to talking about.
Listen, comment, share, let us know on Brandon's channel. Give me your year, make, and model. I will ship you out a free car cover.
But also, like, you got to give me an unusual reason why you need that cover.
Okay, yeah.
Don't just be thinking you're just going to share. And we appreciate it. This is a participation sport. But why do you need that? Why do you need the protection of your car? I need his cover. I want to hear why you need it. You may have an unusual car. Yeah. You may have a love affair with that automobile, and you may need to protect it. Whatever your case is, make it. My man's going to try to give away a couple of these
things. I will give away a couple of these.
You know what I'm saying? I cannot believe this story. I got to tell you, because this is so simple. Yeah. And would you say right now, on a scale of 1 to 10, where are you? 10 being where you... I mean, where this thing could really go, and one being just getting started.
I would say we're at maybe a 4. You know, we're maybe out of four. But like I said, there's three strengths that we have. Yeah. We have a customer-focused shopping experience. You come to our website. We had somebody that works at Amazon come to our website, shop, and be blown away. They're like, yeah, I'm working. I'm sitting in Amazon right now. I just visited your website, talked to somebody in the live chat. The product just loaded automatically on my screen, add to cart, and the thing ships, right?
Not selling on Amazon, though.
We had a customer who works at Amazon.
But why not sell on Amazon?
That's what we're doing now.
You're looking at it.
Okay. So now we're moving.
So you're going to expand a little bit.
Now we're going to start to expand in some of these other retailers. So our customer-focused experience, right? Two is we're really good at direct advertising. I mean, we're able to put our shopping experience in front of the person looking for that exact product at that exact moment.
How?
Right? So basically, what we didn't do is build an online shopping mall, right? We're the guys that, if you're looking for maybe red shoes, we're the guys that'll build, you know, redshoes.com. So we're building a whole experience around one product. So when you come to our website, you have very little search to do. You know, exactly what you need right away.
And so, like, would you do a search? Like, are you able to kind of just focus on your advertising to anybody that mentions that they just bought a new car? All of a sudden, now I get the ad. Or
so basically, what we do is when you go to Google, you'll type in, maybe you put like BMW car covers, right? So we'll have that BMW ad there. As soon as you clicked on that, it goes to a BMW landing page, and you literally are filling in maybe your model, and your product ships out. So targeting our shopping experience in front of the people that are looking for it at that moment. And then what we do is we'll remarket too, of course. So the guy clicks on the on that ad, talks to an agent, isn't 100% sure, but interested, we'll get their email. You'll get a series of nurturing emails where we let you know more about the product and sort of guide you along. We'll send you our, you know, how to shop for a car cover. And then we'll do our social media retargeting ads. If you're on Instagram, if you're on Facebook, you'll continue to see more information about how to shop for a car cover, more information about us.
How big is your list now at this point? Yeah. Now you got car enthusiasts.
Yeah.
And my question is, what else? Like I always ask, what else? Because if I bought a car cover, is there other accessories that you're thinking about getting into, or you're going to stay focused and hyper-focused?
So that's the thing now. Now we're starting to build that list out. You know, we have almost 600,000 customers. We have all their year, make, and models, both boat and vehicle and jet skis.
You know where their heads are at.
So we know exactly what car they have.
Are women into the car thing as much as men now, or more and more, is it more of a male skew?
It is more of a male skew, but we do have some women.
A lot of the commercials now, the car commercials, where women are now, it used to be so male skewed, like women didn't decide. The last time I decided the car we're going to buy in my house was like, I think when I was like 18, and that's when, you know, my mother let me pick my car out. But I mean, women decide what cars you're getting most of the time, but are they enthusiasts? Or because I know they weigh in on the buy, but you don't see women saying I got this Ferrari or whatever as much as you see men doing that.
We're seeing that trending up though. So it is heavily male skewed right now, but we are seeing that trending up. So you'd be surprised how many women are, you know, buying motorcycles. You know, that's that to us, that blew our mind, that we were completely shocked, and how passionate they are about their bike. You know, and a lot of them were in bike crews of other women as well. So stuff like that. So really interesting things that we're starting to learn from our analytics as we start to study our customers and understand, you know, who they are, what are their interests, right? And so yeah, we're moving into new products now. Now we're moving into, like I said, trunk organizers. For us is, we want to.
What's a trunk organizer?
So a trunk organizer is basically.
I think I need a trunk. Do you need a trunk organizer?
Yeah.
Ben, do you need a trunk organizer? Is your trunk like all screwed up? Tell me the truth, honestly.
It's pretty clean.
Not too much.
You know his trunk is like, he's got like one thing in
there.
Ben
looks like
a
pretty clean cut guy.
Like my
so
trunk
I believe,
is
I believe
a disaster.
Him.
Like it's got books. It's got a basketball. All kinds of crap. It doesn't show me well. I need that trunk.
Yeah,
organizer.
I mean, a trunk organizer is just a really simple product that you leave in your trunk. It's foldable. It turns in almost into like a little folder, but it expands out. You could, let's say you had one in the back, you went to buy groceries. You can kind of fill that up and use that to bring the groceries to your house, right?
Wow,
so
cool.
It's just like a basic little thing that's really lightweight, easy, portable, and it just makes it easier for you to sort of maximize your trunk space.
What's the most exciting thing? You talked about, you know, that loneliness, right? Going home at night. Which is no question, even no matter what level of entrepreneur you're at, there's always buckets as you're growing and figuring out what else or what you're missing or what's next, that moment of uncertainty, loneliness. But Are you still feeling that? And what else? Like, what's the next thing?
So for
that,
us,
you know, the next level where you're nervous again?
For sure. That's a great question. That's an awesome question. So I would say the next level for us right now is establishing our brand, right? So we've been really good at direct marketing. But now what we want to do is study our customers, identify other products, and build a brand that we can leverage to expand to other products. Because what we want Sealskin to stand for is whether it's a Sealskin car cover or a Sealskin trunk organizer or a Sealskin roof bag, we want you to know that you're getting the best product at the best price.
What the hell is that on your shirt?
It's our logo.
That's a seal?
It's a seal. But he's
That's bullshit. He's kind of like an automobile or something. I mean, seal. I would think you're in the animal business.
He's like a Superman seal, Brandon. He's
I'm not with you on it. We're gonna have to change your logo. Okay. I mean, do you agree with me out there? I mean, that should be an automobile.
Feedback on our logo, guys. Yeah, feedback on our logo.
The seal skin. I get what you're trying to say with the name.
Yeah, yeah.
But it should say seal skin car cover. Yeah. Could be that you could have the car covers.
Well, we have boat covers and we have jet ski covers and
so
we have other things as well. So
that's true. So if you did car, it would limit you.
It would limit us only car. So we've got a bunch of other vehicles. It's so
tricky.
For us, it's like, you know, the seal's been working really well up until now.
You're loving the seal.
We've got a little seal costume, a little mascot.
I mean, so Navy SEALs is in do with a seal, everybody knows what a Navy SEAL is. So maybe you're right. Maybe you got to go with the seal. The seal is a fun animal that everybody loves.
We'll go to car shows in our mascot. Yeah. Brandon, you'd be surprised how many people are now not paying attention to their vehicles and trying to figure out what the seal is doing.
Now, are you rock and rolling at car shows? Do you sell your product at car shows?
We do.
So you do exhibits?
Exactly.
You're on premise.
We're demonstrating our product and how it works at different car shows and trying to learn more about different markets.
Is that just print money at those shows for you?
Well, I mean,
is it like that?
It's something new that we're doing, so we're learning more about it, but we're loving the interest.
Will you be at the auto show next month in New York City? The biggie.
I will be at the auto show next month, absolutely.
That's a biggie.
Yeah, no, without a doubt.
I love your product, man. I got to tell you, I love the trunk organizer because you're getting right to the core of the matter of entrepreneurism, which is serving, solving a problem, and thinking about what the customer needs, not thinking about what you got to go sell and make a number.
Yeah, for sure.
I love that.
So for us, we want our brand to stand for tough, durable, waterproof, breathable, whatever product we put our name on, know that you got it for the best price possible, know that it's going to be easy to buy, and know that it's going to be a quality product. That's what we want people to understand, right? For us now, it's telling that story, though, Brandon, because we're good at putting those ads in front of customers searching at that moment. We've got to move up that funnel. Right?
How do you get the word out?
So how do we get the word out? Because right now, basically, we look at it as a funnel, right? The bottom of that funnel are people searching for the product at that moment. But as you try to get to before they're searching, you got to move up that funnel. And so now we're starting to, you know, raise our brand awareness and try to build a community around our product. And that's where we're at right now. And that's the biggest challenge we're facing.
Do you go to these big, these antique car shows like in Phoenix and in Florida? They have those big...
Well, literally, it's something that we're just exploring now. You know,
that would be cool. Yeah, those people taking their... That's the love affair,
for sure,
right?
So everything from attending these different car shows, creating content. Yeah. These are the things that we're doing. Finding the right partners. In fact, I know a lot of entrepreneurs, watch your show. So if you're interested in our story and feel like you can help or contribute, I'd love to network with people who are.
I love you got one thing going.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes so many people come in, they got so many different things going, but you got one thing going. We're focused.
We
can sit here for 2 hours.
Yeah, we're focused.
What's the name of those shows, by the way? The big car auction shows with all the vintage cars. That's really well known. That's from Arizona. They're on TV all the time. I can't believe I watched that.
We just did a show with Motor Trends.
It's
called Performance
about?
TV.
What's the name of that? What's the name? Anybody know the name of those big auctions out there that they show? Because you should advertise in that. That's a quick little direct-to-consumer ad that you do at 30 seconds and split the revenue with the TV station.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, I mean,
if you're watching that.
No.
Sierra auction?
No. That's not the big one that has that's really well known for vintage cars. They do one in Phoenix. They do one in Florida. They're huge. And now on TV, a lot of times they're on ESPN2 on the weekends. And I'm just thinking, like, if you're sitting there watching that, how great would be a direct response ad with an athlete that's a collector of cars talking about how they protect his cars with that?
I'd love that. Brandon, you're
I'm giving a phone number so the guy gets credit. You're only paying a play.
Yeah.
You're only paying on success. So you go to the cable company, you're buying their remnant space. Mm-hmm. Every one of them they sell, The cable company gets X. Now I got an athlete in there. They get X, and you get the rest. Awesome. And then all of a sudden, you're getting the branding. Everybody's making money using all the dead space. Who's buying? I don't think they're selling a lot of commercials. Yeah. What was the name of it?
It's Barrett Jackson.
Barrett Jackson. Yeah. How odd is that?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know if you've ever been. I've been to Barrett Jackson. Just amazing. Yeah. But that would be unbelievable to advertise on that auction.
Yeah,
and just do a direct response, and you know something, only paid if you only paid a click.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, we're starting to explore that. That's a great idea. You know, that's definitely an awesome idea.
We got something out of the show now. How great is this guy though? How great is this company? I love the focus.
Yeah, yeah.
I always say, "What the focus are you talking about?" And I know exactly what you're talking about. I don't have that kind of love affair with my car, but when I had like an older vintage car, I'd say I gotta have a sealskin cover, awesome. No question, right?
That absolutely.
If you have a love affair with your car, you need a sealskin cover. You have to, right?
You do. Whether it's a car or a boat or a jet ski, sealskin covers would
How big can your business get?
I mean, we feel like we could probably get to anywhere from $50 to $100 million. You know, for us, we feel like it's the kind of business where if we're everywhere, and also we got to remember there is no king of our space. You know, we look at, you know, companies like WeatherTech, you know, and they've really crushed it when it comes to like car floor mats, right? So for us, that's who we want to be when it comes to.
Do you worry about people stealing your idea and doing it themselves?
I mean, there's always that worry. I mean, everyone could copy any idea, but a lot of times it's not about the idea; it's about the execution. You know, it's about the focus, about the people behind it, it's about the story behind it. You know, so for us, it's like in terms of worrying about is other people going to steal our idea. I mean, you know, that's something that we don't even kind of even worry about. We just want to focus on what we're doing and, you know, find the right people that we're working with and continue with our game plan.
Advice to people out there that have an idea, now knowing what you know, what do you tell your 21-year-old self? And to the people out there that are thinking about taking that big step.
I would say probably two things. One is it's definitely okay to not know what you're doing when you're 20 years old, 21 years old. You know, there's this pressure where you need to sort of figure everything out. I would say, you know, don't worry about it too much. As long as you're not going into debt, right? You know, not sort of, you know, getting into things that are going to derail you completely. Don't worry about it too much. Two is you've got to do networking. You've got to be out there building relationships. It doesn't even matter if you have anything to sell, right? You have yourself to sell. You're a personal brand. You're a brand within yourself. So if you're 21 years old and you want to start a business and you don't know what you want to do, go out there. Go to meetup.com, right? And put entrepreneurs, put different keywords, business associations, join these different groups. And that's what I wish I would have done earlier. You know, so instead of sitting, I see it this way. There's probably two ways to get into business. You can either invent something and be an inventor or discover something. You know, that's how I look at it, right? And to me, I'm not the smartest guy in the world. I can't sit in a room and just invent anything. I'm not even going to bet on myself to do that. But if I go out there and I meet people, I feel like I might be able to discover something. And so I tell entrepreneurs, hey, listen, if you're an inventor, hey, that's more power to you. Amazing. You know, that's just incredible. But if you're not, if you know yourself and you're not sitting, go out there and meet people, right?
I look at you as an improver.
Yeah.
I think, you know, you want to invent something, you want to improve something. And both are extremely powerful methods to do well. You know, when you improve something, you're taking something, but you know it could be better. You know it's not resolving all the issues that it has in the marketplace. You took a product that was underachieving. You were
That's
like,
a great way to put it. That's a great way to put it.
You improved it.
That's a great
and
way.
And you saw a much bigger picture.
Yeah.
You saw a lot more depth, and you took it to a level of quality. You took it to a level that made it easy for people.
For sure.
Right?
That's
I mean, I love the click and pick. Not enough people think about it. I'm constantly thinking about it, even our own website, and it's so hard because at the end, what people really want, as we could see Amazon blowing up, they want easy.
They do.
People want simple and easy, and they'll actually even pay a little more for it.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what you provided, right?
Yeah. No, for sure.
You improved it. You made it happen, dude.
For us, when we look at the web, we feel like if you're not going to be in Amazon, you might as well almost be the opposite of Amazon. That's how we think of it. So instead of building an online mall, which might be, you know, really difficult to do, niche out. Right, pick a product that you can really offer a better experience, better customer service. And so, you know, Amazon may be better at e-commerce, but they may not be better at selling car covers than you, right? Because they're not going to be able to provide the same service niched into their product because they're offering millions of products.
But what I would do is I go on eBay, right out to the, you know, where they have a gazillion cars that people are actually buying a zillion cars on eBay. Yeah. They're not selling them on Amazon yet, and I would target market the hell out of that. But I guess the question I ask all of you, are you an inventor or an improver? And are you finding the what else right now that's going on in your life? And just that's not a business decision when you think about what else. It's a life decision about how your mindset works when you think about what else, whether it be how you can cross the street better, whether you can protect the car that you love better, whether you can actually communicate with your wife better, whatever the what else is, whatever you're dealing with at the time, always has to close out that thought with what else. And can I improve this? Can I make this better? Is there a need for this? Can I serve? Can I solve? And can I differentiate myself in the marketplace so that I could one day could be the best at it? That's entrepreneurism 101. Hey, this has been great. Thank you. Closing remarks. And besides, hey, go to this website if you need to protect your car because the stuff's really good.
Yeah, no, I guess just a closing remark. If there's anyone out there that's really good at storytelling, we feel like we have an interesting story to tell, definitely reach out to me. You know, go to sealskincovers.com, go to our Contact Us page, and reach out to Brandon or comment on the page there. And more power to young entrepreneurs. And that's why I want to do a little bit of what you're doing, Brandon, when I get there, you know. And I want to reach out because I feel like that's huge. I mean, to me.
Yeah, promote entrepreneurism. That's what this country is. I wouldn't be surprised. About this country and this world and what we got going on.
I wouldn't be surprised if this. If I look back, Brandon, this ends up being a really game changer in my life. This podcast alone, you know, things like this mean a lot to me. You know, things that sort of help me step out of my comfort zone, things that I can learn from, open up my horizons. And this is one of those things. So, you know, if you see me 10 years from now, 5 years from now, come back and just thank you for this.
I'm going to see you. I'm going to see you 5 or 10 years from now, and I'm proud of you, man. I can't believe what you've accomplished, and I love the simplicity of it. Good for you, man.
Thank you, Brandon.